podcast on the Kaweka Road, about 6k from the road end, climbing up to quite a high, 900, 1000 metres, into the gloom.
Well, there goes the stress-free insurance. Not far from the road end now. Still gloomy out there. Lawrence is rally driving.
It's the Green Bay Packer. Makahu Saddle road end, just getting ready to head off up the hill. A little bit clearer here than it was on the way up, which bodes well. Just one car in the car park. We are here. Head up past this hut up there tonight, and then up there tomorrow, around here, down here, stay there, and then back here for our 2-day trip to the Kawekas. First hut just near the road end. Nobody in?
No one's home.
No one's home. It's a little road end hut and a cow saddle hut for bunker. As the mountains start to appear from the mist, climb up.
It does seem that it's kind of like
just up to Dominey Hut today, just an hour or so above the car park, I think. Climbing pretty quickly, 400 or 500 metres up. Still pretty murky out there, but getting the feeling of climbing for sure. Bit of a damp day. Hopefully clearer tomorrow. Maybe even an inversion, that'd be nice. Yeah, so we reckon 150 metres to go up this zigzaggy ridge. Maybe on that one above us, we will find the bivvy. The clearing mists of the evening, with half an hour to dark. We just came up Trial Spur, and Makahu Spur is that way. And they come together here. And we reckon the bivvy's just on that lump up there. Dommy bivvy, free for the night, which is nice, no tents, just set up. The gathering gloom of a Kaweka evening light. Nice little compact snore box, two bunks. Well, here we are, 7:15, Dommy Briv, dinner done. Lawrence.
Hello, camera.
Hello, camera. Yeah, I've got quite a few of you saying that. Oh, well, only 12 hours to go till the morning. Bolt the door. Shelter from the storm. Morning a little bit clearer, but not completely. Clouds blowing out on the top still. A loo with a view. Oops. A bit windy this morning, but clear views at last. Now, a bit blowy today. A bit maybe about 100 metres to the top, and then we head back the way you've come. another ridge line into the hut. A lunch stop. A little bit of sun at last on the descent to the hut. A bush lawyer, or wait a minute, plant here. That vine way of the trees with hooks normally catches you. Haven't seen quite as much of that in one spot before. As we head down the track. Loads. Not too far to the junction and then not far to the hut. Good bit of tramping history here. Here's the old fashioned painted tin, Primaloft, I think they call them, markers that used to be used, and of course now the famous dock plastic marker that we see everywhere today. It's funny how often you see the old tin one still. The junction pretty much the hut, slightly less I reckon. And then we're out tomorrow to my Makahu Saddle. So nearly at the hut. Bit of an overview of the trip. We flew down yesterday, Friday. 1 o'clock flight, got here just after two. Jumped in a hire car, drove to road end. Hour and 10 minutes up to Vivi last night. It's quite nice little walk in the evening, and that broke up the next day, so we have another 200-300 meters up to the top of the first summit, Kaweka J, and then along the bridge. Unfortunately no views for us today, just wind and cloud. Very reminiscent of tops of British mountains, because the cloud and because the wind. Anyway, still nice, undulating, fairly flat in places. Over Kaweka North, its little trig, and then on to Metahu, I think, I'm not sure anyway, the last peak, which is 1650. Just beyond that, and then drop down to the east on the ridge that I'm on now. We're going to Middle Hill Hut, I think it is, which is a four bunker. And tomorrow, last day, I'll come back up this little bit of track for half an hour and then turn left and head back to the car via Kaweka Flats Bivvy. Possibly go to the old iron historic hut tomorrow. Yeah, I think the weather is generally mild, just a bit windy and cloudy on the tops throughout our 3 days in the Kaweka Forest Park. I'm definitely rocking the peachy orangey coloured huts around here. Middle Hill Hut. Whiff of a fire maybe. See how he's going.
Hello.
Hello. Just us, it looks like. Awesome.
Six bed,
is it? Okay. Oh, we're going to get that fire going, something rotten, I'll tell you. That's nice.
Lawrence's firework looking good. Toasty here.
Particularly cute hut, has to be said. Drop a lot of this orange around here. All the huts seem to be the same colour. Middle Hill Hut. And its surrounds. On another trip we went to Makino Hut, and that's 4 or 5 hours that way. Sika. Day 3. Heading to Kaweka Flats and out to Makahu Road End. Kaweka Flats, I presume. Now and up between here and there, Kaweka's. And Makahu Saddle. Distance. Some ridge down. A lovely little 300 meter drop. 250 up the other side. Opposite flats. Number 3 in the continuing history of track markers in New Zealand. Old paint tin lids. Painted. In fact, you can see all three there with the dock marker and then a Primaloft tin marker in the background. Mellow River crossing and up the other side. Oh god! Up. That way. Iron Ferry Hut. As Lawrence now knows, notable for its vertical totara slabs and the fact that it's not built on flat ground. Is there a toilet? Oh, there is, over there somewhere. Water 100 meters away. Let us see what's inside. Good old wood floor. And two bunks. Nice. Oh. So it was
built before 1882, one of the oldest huts in New Zealand.
Kaweka Flats live. The ridge we went up for this day.
Into the clouds, the hut is on that sort of hump in the middle there. Just about make it out.
This drainage up the other side, and then back to Makahu Saddle over the back there. Not too far now, an hour and a bit.
Moving to the country, I'm gonna eat a lot of peaches. I'm moving to the country, I'm gonna eat me a lot of peaches. I'm moving to the country, I'm gonna eat a lot of peaches. I'm moving to the country, I'm gonna eat a lot of peaches.
Tramp for a while in New Zealand when Lawrence moves to Australia. Above the Mohaka. The stairway to heaven.
An auspicious moment.
An auspicious moment, there you go.
Lawrence's last dip while a resident of New Zealand.